Hello students, I'll be teaching you elections in India. Now, before starting this chapter, let me ask you some interesting questions. Do you know who is the present president of India? I think you all know this. Do you know who is the prime minister of India? Where is the parliament of India located? Who was the first president of India? Who was the first prime minister of India? Please try to find out the answers. If you already know this, please write down at page 41. Okay? Now take out page 42. In the democratic form of government that we have, people choose representatives to form the government. The process of electing a leader is known as election. Now, why is it important to vote? It is important to cast our vote during elections. The main reasons for this are as follows. It is our right and we must exercise it. Democracy depends upon it. If we are not happy with the government, we can vote against it. Every vote counts. If we do not cast our vote, the wrong persons may get elected and form our government. This will harm our country. Now we will try to understand the process of election. With a population of over 1.21 billion, India is the largest democracy in the world. Evidently, the largest democratic electoral exercise in the world is also conducted here. Let us find out how it is done. Elections are held at regular intervals to select representatives of the people. Through elections, people can also reject the representatives who had been chosen in the previous elections if they are not satisfied with their performances. When elections are held across a country to elect representatives to the Parliament of India, they are known as general elections. When elections are held to elect representatives to the state lawmaking body, they are known as assembly elections. Sometimes by-elections take place when the representative already chosen in regular elections is unable to function properly in that capacity anymore due to some reason. For the general elections, our country has been divided into 543 territorial divisions known as constituencies. People residing in a constituency elect one person from among different candidates who represent them in the Lok Sabha, which is the lower house of the parliament. For assembly elections, the states are further divided into smaller constituencies and a representative is elected from each one of them to the respective state legislative assembly. Some constituencies are reserved for the weaker sections of the society who can't compete with other candidates due to lack of resources such as money, social status, influence, because of their gender. Weaker sections include scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and women. After the nomination of candidates, campaigning for the elections begins. In this phase, the nominate candidates interact with the voters and address gatherings to mobilize support in their favor. Campaigning also gives people a chance to know the candidates better and choose the best representative from among the number of candidates. In a democracy, every candidate is free to conduct their election campaign whichever way they want to. The election day is the day when the voters cast their vote. Earlier, ballot papers were used for this purpose. Now they have been replaced by the electronic voting machines, EVS. Once the polling is over, all electronic voting machines are sealed and taken to a secured place. They are opened and the votes secured by each candidate are counted. The candidates getting the maximum number of votes in each constituency are declared winners. After it becomes clear who the winning candidates are, the political party with the maximum number of winning candidates forms the government. Now, responsibilities of a good citizen. We live in a society and are a part of it. Whatever happens in the society affects us. Therefore, it is important for us to make sure that we carry out our duties as a responsible citizen. Some of our responsibilities are as follows. We must respect our country and take pride in being a citizen of it. We must always be loyal to our country. We must cast our vote. We must protect the environment and resources of our country. We must respect each other. We must respect public property. We must follow rules and laws. We must keep our surroundings clean. We must believe in the dignity of labor. And we must be compassionate. I think, children, this explanation will help you. Thank you.